Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. Today I am going to teach you about rotating magnetic field and what it is and how it works. First of all, we all know to run a three-phase motor, we need a three-phase supply R, Y and B. And we know for induction motor, we give this R, Y and B supply to stator of the motor. And whenever we give the give this three-phase supply to the motor, a rotating magnetic field is created that helps to run the rotor of the motor, and that's how motor works. But the question is, how this rotating magnetic field is created? Because in single phase, a static magnetic field is created. It fluctuates but doesn't rotate. But in three-phase supply, the magnetic field it produces, it rotates itself. And how this has happened? So I'm going to teach you this. First of all, we need to draw a three-phase supply waveform, three-phase waveform. To draw a three-phase waveform, I will show you an easy way to draw a three-phase sinusoidal waveform. First of all, you need to draw like this. And now join this angle. And this angle too. So this is one sinusoidal waveform. This is another sinusoidal waveform. I don't have three different color, otherwise I would draw these three waveform in different color. This should help you to understand, but doesn't matter, I will explain it further. Let's say, now let's draw x-axis and y-axis. I just made a mistake. I draw this line in a wrong place. This line will be here. And this is one waveform. And this is Y. This is X, this is Y. Let's say this waveform, this one, is R phase. And this waveform is Y phase, and this waveform is B phase, and every phase is 120 degree apart from each other. So I can draw this like this fashion. This is R, this is Y, and this is B. So every phase is 120 degree apart from each other. Now let's take a point somewhere here in this point. When supply is at this point, R phase is at peak, positive peak, and other two phase is negative, and that too magnitude is half, not full. This is Y phase. Y phase is here, negative peak. But here negative, but magnitude is half. Similarly, Y phase, B phase, magnitude is here full, negative peak. So here negative and magnitude is half. So somewhere at this point, if we take this point, magnitude, magnetic field for R phase will be positive, and magnetic positive, this is positive and highest. So at this point, magnetic field for R phase will be around at this direction, R phase, and magnitude is highest. So at this direction. And for other two phase, for Y phase, magnetic field will be negative and half. Direction of Y is at this, this is the direction of Y. So negative direction will be here in this way. So magnetic field will be half in this direction, and magnitude will be half. This is Y. And for B phase at this point, magnetic field will be negative and magnitude will be half. Direction of B is here in this. So negative will at this point in this way. So negative and magnitude will be half. So if we break these two vector B and Y, we'll get two factor. One is B sine theta, and one is B cos theta. Same fashion, if we break this Y vector, one will be Y sine theta, and another one in this direction will be, sorry, this is R, this was R. So R, Y cos theta. So B sin theta, vector part of B will be around Y axis, B sin theta and B cos theta. Vector for Y, B Y sin theta and Y cos theta. B sin theta and Y sin theta will cancel each other, and resultant magnetic field will be in this direction. And magnitude will be R plus B cos theta plus Y sin theta. So what we see here, when the magnitude is, when the magnitude is positive for Y, resultant magnetic field is in the direction of Y. Direction of R. When the magnetic field for Y, R is at highest point, magnetic field for this will be at this direction. Similarly, if we take another point around this point, where Y phase will be at positive peak and other two phase will be negative, and magnitude will be half. So for that case, for positive Y phase, magnetic field will be in this direction, and magnitude will be full peak. And other two phase will be negative, and magnitude will be half. So B and R is negative, and we know direction of B is this. So negative B will in this direction. B and R is positive, and here R is negative. So negative R is here in this direction, and magnitude will be half. So resultant magnitude will be, if we break this part vector sum, this is B sine theta, this is R sine theta, this is B cos theta, this is for R cos theta. So resultant magnetic field is in this direction. This P sin theta and R sin theta will cancel each other. So resultant direction will be in this direction when Y phase is at peak. Y and magnitude will be Y plus P cos theta plus R cos theta. When R was at peak, direction of the resultant magnetic field was in the direction of phase R, and magnitude was R plus B cos theta plus Y sin theta. Y cos theta. And same here. And similarly, when you take the point at around here in this point, when the B phase is at peak, same fashion, the direction of the resultant magnetic field will be in the direction of phase B. So, in this direction. And magnetic field will be B plus Y cos theta plus R cos theta. So now we can see, we have done nothing here. We just given three phase supply, and magnetic field of the resultant magnetic field direction is changing in every second of every interval. First it was in this direction, then it gone to this direction, and then to this direction. So if we plot this in a circle, this will help us understand easily. First, the magnetic field direction was in this direction. Then it goes to in this direction. Automatically, a rotating magnetic field is generated without doing anything. We just given three phase supply here. That's how a rotating magnetic field is created. And for motor, if this is stator and this is rotor, in terminal box we give three phase supply R, Y and B. Whenever we give three phase supply, a rotating magnetic field is created inside the stator like this fashion, and this induces a voltage in the rotor. And we know the rotor coil is shorted from both end, so a induced voltage results in a circulating current. And we know from Faraday's law of induction, if we place a current carrying conductor inside a magnetic field, it will experience a force. This conductor will experience a force, and thus that force will be calculated from this equation BIL sin theta. I will explain these in later videos. So due to this experienced force, rotor will start rotating. So now you have understood how a rotating magnetic field helps to run a motor. Thank you very much.